One of my earliest videos was a quick spotlight on Rune Factory 4, and in it I said that the future of the series was in doubt, and it really was at the time. Rune Factory 5 being announced years later was the absolute last thing I ever expected. Honestly, I couldn't be happier. While we're waiting for Rune Factory 5 though, Marvelous have given us an enhanced port of the very game that was the subject of that early video. Titled Rune Factory 4 Special, it should be available worldwide on the Nintendo Switch by the time this video is live. This was a really good move by Marvelous for multiple reasons. It's a great game for one, but when the original Rune Factory 4 launched on the 3DS, it was during a period I like to call the "fuck everyone except America" period in the 3DS's life cycle. It was a time when games from certain publishers either wouldn't get a release outside America at all, or a release outside America was uncertain until it randomly stealth released as a digital only title a year and a half after the American one. Rune Factory 4 fell into the latter category, at least in some regions. In a post-Animal Crossing New Leaf world, Rune Factory 4 should be getting a lot more attention. It is one of the best life sim games out there, and it's also very important in that it's a life sim game for people who don't really get what the genre is all about. That's because it's actually the perfect blend of a life sim RPG and a dungeon crawling RPG. There is enough here that's familiar to people who've never touched a life sim before, and that makes absorbing the multitude of mechanics as they deepen further and further a lot easier. With the Rune Factory series being a spin-off of the Harvest Moon Story of Seasons series, it's probably no surprise that the gameplay element with the most depth in Rune Factory 4 Special is the farming. Starting off incredibly simple, layers upon layers are quickly added, and it always feels somewhat central to the game and the gameplay loop, even when there are dungeons to explore and big scary boss monsters to destroy. Among the other things you'll be doing in Rune Factory 4 Special, the most notable are fairly expansive cooking and crafting systems and building relationships with everyone in the town of Selphia. There are a lot of other minigame-centric things in the game too, like fishing and little games and challenges that take place during festivals. You can also complete a number of requests each day, which are basically little quests. There is actually a shitload of things to do in this game, and unlike a lot of similar games with a day-night system, you aren't forced to go to sleep every night. You will get some penalties, but you can easily make it through at least a few in-game days without resting your head on a pillow. It highlights a lot of what this game does right amongst its peers in the life sim RPG genre. It basically lets you play how you want and at your own pace. There's a lot of freedom and you aren't rushing against timers or worrying about missables. It really cements its place, in my mind, as the perfect entry point into the genre. Apart from doing all the life sim stuff really well, the game itself has style, and there's plenty of humor to be found in the writing. Characters of significance, and there are a lot of them, are introduced with short but beautiful anime sequences. The premise of the story is ridiculous, but it's acutely aware of that, which helps it shine. Not that the story itself is uninteresting on its own, there's just enough intrigue to keep you going, while the writing is sure to make you laugh and maybe even cry. I don't really have any complaints, but there is one little aspect that carried over from the 3DS version that does confuse me a little. There is voice acting in the game, but it's shockingly limited and the implementation is perplexing at times. Only some characters get a voice that actually says sentences instead of grunts and single words like hi and yes. But even those characters that do get to actually speak entire sentences only speak one or two lines in an entire conversation, seemingly at random.
Oh well, this happens all the time too. Don't worry about it. But anyway, I'm pleased to meet you. Yeah.
I really would have liked to see this expanded in Rune Factory 4 Special. Even as limited as it is, the voice acting in the game is mostly fantastic. Why not add more of it? In any case, with how large the game is and how great it is overall, the voice acting thing is just a little quibble. It shouldn't surprise you at this point that I 100% recommend this game, to tide over the hungry Animal Crossing fans until New Horizons drops, and to those who have either never tried a life sim before or didn't quite like the last one they tried. Be warned though, it can get extremely addictive. Don't go blaming me if you accidentally stay up 3 nights in a row, just like you make your character do in the game. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all soon.
Thanks for the liking, subscribing, and the sharing!